Eddie loved the JBL character.
Mm-hmm.
He loved JBL against himself, the Eddie character. So it was the most fun I've ever had.
Talk to me a little bit more about Eddie, because I know we've had conversations before about what he meant to you, not only personally, but to your career. Elaborate a little bit more about that.
Yeah, without Eddie, there's no JBL, period. JBL was a one and done. That was it. And Eddie wanted to prove that he could make anybody, I think. And plus, we were very, very close friends. I gave part of the eulogy at his funeral. He was one of my groomsmen in my wedding. We were close friends, and he wanted to see me succeed. And sometimes at the expense of his own character. And without Eddie, there wouldn't have been a JBL. I remember one time we were in Japan, and I got in that Japan mindset. And after the match, I told Eddie, I said, that just didn't work. And he goes, I don't know what happened. He called me like he does at 2 o'clock in the morning. He goes, S.A., you weren't JBL. You were John Hawk. He goes, you were a badass. He goes, you got to beg.
Yeah.
And the next night, I go out there with Eddie, and I'm firing up just like before. And at one point, I backed off, and the people in Japan started booing, which at that time, they really didn't do back then. But that was Eddie helping me with the character. He really developed the character. I remember one time we were in a match. We followed The Undertaker, which is always a death wish, because The Undertaker, I love him. He's like a brother to me. I had the most respect for him as probably anybody in the world. But he would go on before – if he went before you, he would have such a good match you couldn't follow it. And he would do it on purpose. He'd go out there and he would just tear the house freaking down. It was ungodly how good he was, especially when he had to go on ahead of you. So me and Eddie are on last, and I'm watching Taker, and this match is just amazing. It's 30-something minutes, a live event. And I said, S.A., what are we going to do? And she goes, I don't know. This is really good. So we get out there, and right away I'm thinking we're going to go to the top rope, we're going to go to the crowd. And Eddie goes, get the headlock, S.A. And I said, okay. So then I called a spot. I'm going to go outside the ring. She goes, stay here. I said, okay. So I stay there for a second. Then I get ready to go outside again. He goes, stay here. Well, the crowd had been so high with The Undertaker. And all of a sudden, the crowd starts getting lower and lower. And finally, they're just sitting there talking to each other. And they're bored. We're sitting there in a headlock forever. And then Eddie goes, okay, now it's time, S.A. And we slowly built them back up. And as we left, they were all on their feet again. And it was just, it was Eddie Guerrero's mindset of, you know, I panicked. Eddie didn't. He knew what to do. And that's how much Eddie helped everybody, but especially me. Without Eddie Guerrero, there's no JBL.
Awesome. Can't say it any more succinctly than that. You like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Apple Podcasts. Subscribe now and never miss an episode.